These days, it is not difficult to teach yourself stenography. However, starting off can be a little daunting. This video serves as an introductory guide for complete beginners wanting to learn English steno as a hobby. Before we start, let's summarize what stenography is, how it works, and why you might want to learn it. Machine stenography, or steno for short, is a method of corded text input that uses specialized keyboards. This means that multiple keys are pressed down all at once in contrast to typing. Although there are only 23 keys on the steno layout, this gives us over 8 million possible key combinations. We call these combinations chords or strokes. Primarily, steno is used for writing English text. A stenographer learns a so-called steno theory, which governs the rules for breaking down complicated words into steno strokes. Most steno theories use a mix of phonetics and orthography to achieve this. We're not simply just memorizing a chord for every word in English. That would be insane. When it comes to non-word translations, we use systems that can be based off of a mix of chord shapes and orthographic principles. Because there are just so many available chords, it is very easy to mesh multiple systems together that allow us to write basically anything that a regular keyword can, not just English words. Some examples include shortcuts, symbols, and movement keys. We can even write stuff like emoji and Greek symbols, which are more difficult to write with normal keyboards. So why would you want to learn steno? After all, you will need to have a special keyboard, and it can take months before you're fluent. Well, there are two main reasons: ergonomics and speed. Here's me typing at 100 words per minute on a mechanical keyboard. And here's me writing at 200 words per minute with my steno keyboard. You can clearly see how much faster and more comfortable steno can be. If you're wondering about use cases outside of monkey type tests, here's me writing and editing LaTeX, writing code, editing a report, and community member Josiah speedrunning Vim Tutor with steno. If this is all very impressive to you, I must warn that it takes a lot of time, patience, and effort to learn. Most people reach 100 words per minute in 6 months to a year with casual practice. I first learned steno in 10th grade, which happened to be during COVID, and I spent anywhere from 1 to 3 hours practicing each day. I started on February 29th of 2020, and by the end of April, I was anywhere from 30 to 50 words per minute. In May, I was completing some quotes at 100 words per minute, and by the end of July, I was anywhere from 80 to 180 words per minute depending on the type research quote. As for switching to steno full-time, it wasn't until I got my PC in November of 2022, 2.5 years later, that I attempted the challenge. Therefore, my advice is to learn steno as a hobby, not as a quick hack to boost your typing speed. Instead, you should learn steno only if you enjoy the process itself. Think about it as a challenge, like learning a new musical instrument. Everyone starts somewhere, and you can't expect to achieve mastery in a short amount of time. So with all of that out of the way, let's carry on. If you are ever in need of motivation or steno help, I recommend joining the Plover Discord server. It's a great place to learn steno with others, share your progress, and ask any questions that come to mind. We're a very friendly community and are more than happy to help out. Let's first talk steno hardware. To reach a decent speed, it is very helpful to have a good steno keyboard. These are designed to make cording easy by having very light keys and having them arranged in a grid. Although the majority of regular keyboards fail these two requirements, it is still possible to learn steno with one of these. I would only recommend purchasing a dedicated steno keyboard if you are sure about learning steno. I've included some links in the description for some good boards if you are interested in purchasing one. With whatever hardware you are using, let's get it set up. All steno keyboards require a steno engine that translates between the keys you press and the textual output. For some keyboards, this can be embedded within the firmware itself, but for starting off, we will use Plover. This is a free and open source steno app for Linux, macOS, and Windows. Head on over to the installation guide and follow the instructions for your operating system. Once you have installed Plover, follow the relevant sections in this video for your hardware. If you're using a regular keyboard, you should first figure out if it has N key rollover. This is the ability to detect simultaneous key presses. You can check this by going to a keyboard checking site and pressing a bunch of keys. If they all light up, then this is good. Just set Plover to enabled, and you can start pressing some chords right away to see what sort of output you get. When you practice, just make sure to write each stroke like so, with each key being pressed down all at once. On the other hand, if only some keys light up, as shown with my laptop keyboard, that's okay as well. We can work around this by going in Plover's main window, Configuration, Machine, and Enable Arpeggiate. This option will allow you to press each key individually and the spacebar to send the stroke to Plover. This is what it looks like to arpeggiate. To press a chord, I individually press each key and then the spacebar once I am finished. If you have a Hobbyist Steno keyboard, first make sure you have the machine set to Gemini PR. Next, with your Steno keyboard unplugged, go to Configure, Machine, and press the Refresh button. Now, plug in your keyboard, press Refresh, and the new option will be the one you need to use. Please note that even if Plover says connected, you may have the wrong port selected and your keyboard will not work. To test a port, press Apply and open the paper tape. Press a bunch of keys on your keyboard and you should see them show up there. Once you have your machine set up, let's go about writing our first words with Plover. Open Plover's paper tape and a Word document like Google Docs. In Plover's main window, select Output to be enabled, and then focus on the Word document window. Now let's try and write the phrase Hello World. Move your fingers to the H, E, and L keys with your left index, right thumb, and right ring finger. For Steno keyboards and those with N key rollover, press all of these keys simultaneously. If you're arpeggiating, press each key individually, and then the spacebar afterwards. You should see the word HELL and H-E-L in the paper tape. Next, move your fingers to the H, R, O, and E keys like so. Your left index should be in between the cracks of H and R, and your thumbs should be on O and E. After writing this stroke, you should see hello in the Word document and H-R-O-E in the paper tape. Finally, move your fingers to the W, O, R, L, and D keys. You should have your left middle finger on W, left thumb on O, right index finger on R, right ring finger on L, and right pinky on D. You should see world appear and W-O-R-L-D in the paper tape.
Congrats! You just wrote your first words with Steno. So where do we go from here? Well, you should probably choose a Steno theory to learn. As previously discussed, these are the set of rules that help you break down complicated words into the Steno strokes you write. For professional stenographers, there are numerous Steno theories available for purchase that usually come with textbooks. The abundance of Steno theories comes from the fact that there are different ways of translating between words and Steno strokes. It is also a huge effort to create a Steno theory and its learning resources, which is why the vast majority are not free. There are really only two available theories for hobbyists that I can recommend.
First, there is Plover Theory, the default one that comes with the Plover app. This is Mirabai Knight's personal theory she uses for Steno captioning. As a result, it is very fast and somewhat heavy on memorization. The second option you have is Lapwing Theory. This was created for hobbyists, and many consider it as easier to learn and more beginner-friendly. While it is not tried and tested for Steno captioning, it is still quite fast. At the end of the day, it doesn't really matter which theory you learn, even when it comes to speed. It is always possible to add more shortcuts after the fact, which is where much of your speed actually comes from. If you can't decide which theory to learn, I would just suggest Lapwing. It is less frustrating to start off on, more consistent than Plover Theory, and the learning resource is much more comprehensive.
It is also easier to switch from Lapwing to Plover, but not really the other way around once you've learned theory principles. To learn Steno with Lapwing theory, check out the Lapwing for Beginners online book. Chapters 1 to 3 cover how Steno works and the structure of the book, while chapters 4 to 23 cover writing English. Each chapter usually follows the same structure: theory followed by drills, and a final test that reviews everything covered so far. At the end, there are some briefs for you to memorize and some practice sentences to help you learn them. At the very top of each chapter is a suggested length you should spend practicing the concepts, and each practice test comes with a recommended passing requirement.
Keep in mind, these are just recommendations. You may prefer to speedrun the entire book and jump right into the deep end, or you can follow the suggestions down to the fine print.
Once you have gotten to chapter 23, you should be well on your way to becoming proficient at writing English prose with Steno. You may occasionally stumble across difficult words, but feel free to use the lookup tool in these situations. If you are working on building your speed, you can take a look at typing games like Monkey Type or Type Racer, especially if you find those fun. Another common practice technique is to write your strokes to a metronome and gradually increase the BPM. If you'd like to practice like professionals, you can also try audio dictations. There are plenty you can find on YouTube. Just let them play and transcribe what you can hear to the best of your ability.
Try different things and see which practice methods work best for you. As a hobbyist, you'll also probably want to incorporate Steno into your computer usage, whether that's writing emails, chatting with friends, or working on reports. If you haven't already, you should definitely consider purchasing a Steno keyboard as well. And that's really all there is to it, at least for English prose. The Lapwing for Beginners book also covers symbols, shortcuts, and movement keys, so definitely check those chapters out if you are interested in switching to Steno full-time. I hope you found this video helpful, and I wish you the very best of luck in learning Steno.